I'm here to present one of the solutions. So we participated in the Microsoft Teams hackathon in the 2020 in the second quarter of this year, and we are one of the top three winners. So as a two-member team, we built it, and for the 3 weeks challenge, we took it. So I'm going to present that entire solutions here. So the subject was like the Microsoft Teams, the way of transforming the communications and how it's with a great workplace. So to start with, I'm Manoj Mittal, working as an architect and associated with Mindtree Limited. I have with me my co-worker.
Hi, good morning, everyone. I'm Bharti Langan, working as a technical lead in Mindtree Limited.
This is the credentials, what we have participated and we have received. So this is the place, we received as a third place as a Mindtree organizations in this hackathon solution. So moving forward, what problem statement we took for this hackathon? So it was the real-time integration, how we can do from the between the ground and the sky. So that comes what solutions you need to pick up. We have a lot of solutions exist in the market. The Slack is there. So we thought, okay, we have a Teams, and Teams has a lot of rich ecosystem around the M365. Why not take that one and build the solution around that one? So we choose MS Teams. So I'm going to talk about entire this, how we solve the business problem with that one. So this is a very holistic view and divide the business problem into the three sections. And we consume most of the component which exists in the team, which we are going to customize. But the agenda is not to showcase how this tool we can use, but the agenda is how we can solve the business problem using that tool. So just talking about here, the communication sections, how we define the process sections, how we define the personal section. So we'll just talk about more on that one and just showcase in the demo section how all these activity, what we have defined, and this is specific to the airline industry. So as I have a persona, which is some few crew members on the sky as well as on the land, and they are having the Teams on their any of the device, desktop, mobile, or tablet. So how they are going to talk and how we can solve their problems. So if you see here, we have defined the Teams with a specific to the airlines that having a journal channel. And this with the color coding, it's some is the out-of-box component which we use, and some we have built as a custom. So this, as we're talking about airline industry, the passengers, who is the special passengers, challenging passengers, quite important. So that we put it in the journal tab so anybody can see whether it's a ground or the crew members as per their grad. And then we have an admin section. And the admin section, who is the authorized persons, they can do the flight management, so they can change their schedule and see the reportings for this particular. And then we have escalation sections. That is again one different channel. So escalations, the person who's on the launch or in the airports or in the flight, he or she is not well. Somebody need to escalate her to the respective team so to take the actions. So for that purpose, the escalations. But component we have used as a MS Team extensions here. I will showcase those one. Processes one, when the ground member getting a lot of documents for doing their regular jobs, as they are talking with the food industries, they are talking with the invoicings, for that they are getting a lot of invoices, how we can automate entire processes, right? So for that we use the AI builder component to solve this problem of the processes. And then last, the personnel. So if I am a crew member, how I can solve my personnel's problem, how I can check what's my schedule and swap between the my co-worker who is available if I am not well on the particular day. So let's go to the demo. I have a recorded 6 to 7 minutes demo. I will quickly run it. So this is my fictitious flight Osmosis, which our team we have created. Under that journal channels, we have a special tabs we have created, which have a special passengers and the challenging passengers. This is the SPFX component, which we have built, taking the data from external API, dump into the SharePoint and designing the cards here. So we the crew member can select it here, who is the special passenger in my flight is going. Accordingly, they can get the benefits. And who is the challenging passenger in the particular flight, they can filter. And then get all the details which need a more attention. And second channels, I will move to the admin section. Here, admin sections we have, where is the authorized persons is going to assign to that particular channel. The admin person having their own dashboard where they can click on the flight details. They will get listed down all the flights information. So we are going away from the email sections, and they will get the notification directly from there. If anything change within a flight, it's for internal crew members. So once they select any particular flight, come back here, edit, and then change any of the status. It was delayed, now it's scheduled. Once they click on save, come back to the listings, and the real-time data is getting updated. And accordingly, the notification also come using the MS Flow to the particular post area of the particular channels. They will get the advantage for that. Again, we have a reporting and just a high-level reporting, not quite rich here, but just showing the view how the reporting is going to work. So we have a flights here, what flights is going to happen, what type of passengers they have, they will get a glimpse of on the very high level. This particular flight is having, okay, this number of challenging passengers, this number of the special passengers. So accordingly, the services can be taken care within the particular flights. So once we move out from this section, now going to the escalation supports. So this is a again one of the channel which the my crew member is having this particular support from the escalation. They will search any of the passengers from here. They will just check on their boarding pass, what's the name of the person, and search in our system. So those passengers, they will just make it out, figure out, okay, this is the name of the persons and PNR numbers, ticket numbers, and they will get more details. Again, it's coming as adaptive cards, and they will mark it to the at the rate doctor or someone who need to take action more on top of that. And once that person will log in, they will get this card as a more detailed button is there. It has a deep linking to the different tabs what we have. So doctors can click on the more details, and he or she will get the more detail of the passengers, so what was his or her past medical history, and what's their address, and what flight they are going to take. So accordingly, they can take more action. Now moving to the next section, if you see here, I logged in with a different users. I will pause it. I'll just log in with a different users. So this is not that user. So this user is going to just talk it about here, okay, what's my weekly roster? So weekly roster, like my, what's my weekly schedule? So he or she will get the detail of their weekly plan, what the task is assigned to him or her, his or her. So they will get the detail once they click on the particular cards which is coming into the bot, and they will get the more detail of the particular card, what's their flight is going to start, what's the given the gate is going to open, what's the hour. And he or she feel he is not well, click on the swap button. So what the swap button will do, it will post the notification within our Teams using again using the MS Flow. So the request has posted successfully. When I log in with the different users again, then I will find in my post area some the request has appeared. So I'm just moving to the different one. So I will get the request. It will appear here in just a couple of seconds. So here, the that particular user is a different user. He or she is going to accept that particular request. As he or she will accept, the task will assign to that particular person, and he or she will not get that particular task. So let's wait. Yep, it came here. So once this user say the accept swap request, then task is assigned to this particular person. So we can take this use case in a multiple way as a shift management happening in the organizations, and we need to switch the shift and assign to someone else accordingly. Also, that use case can come into the picture. If I go back again to the that particular users who has raised the request, and we'll see what the weekly task assigned to his or her, that we will not get that particular task which he or she asked for the swap. So as we type here my weekly roster, what's my weekly plan, so see the here the task has gone from that particular queue, so the task is not there. So let's there is another section. If you need to search for the document, as this entire ecosystem we are using as a SharePoint as a backend. So we just use the carousel card for the search. If users need to search any relevant documents with there, they can get it from there. Another section is the beverages industry, for the beverages point of view. So it's just going entire touch-free activity, whatever the beverages left within our planes or in the my ground crew member, and they want to note it down what are the food has left over. So we have trained the system using AI builder. So once we upload any particular image, so that image which we have taken via the mobile or which we have in system, for example, I took this image and that is a leftover component is available. So as soon as I upload, it will go to the models what we have defined into the AI builder, and within a minute we'll get the response back. So what is the count is available. So no need to note it down in the paper and hand it over and send an email. We'll just post that post into the channel itself, and the active team will get an idea what the food has left over, and accordingly they can plan their capacity for the next flights or their next journeys. Okay, the another section here is a private tab which we created. It's just a PNP control. We just took it from there and just deployed as per the need. And here in this worldwide news, we have configured the news as specific to the airline. So this control is quite configurable, available in PNP library. We just define, okay, this is news is specific to the PNP library to get the more feel. It's one common place everybody will get the response. So as you, I come back on the left beverages, when you see here, the response has came in the meantime, how many cans I have and what the count of the can will get here. And this is get stored into the my file folder structures itself. And this is the invoice processing basically. So when I'm getting the emails from the any of the vendor, and I've defined the some rules, and then based on the rules, the files is getting stored into the particular library. Once it's getting stored into the library, then we are getting the notification in the post section itself. And there, yeah, here I'm getting all the files which is getting stored. And then post sections, we are getting notification how many is processed invoices, how many is pending invoices. And again, having a button deep linking to the particular tab. Once I click it here, I will get, okay, these are the invoices which has already processed in the system, which we have done. We can get the more detail for that particular invoice. If I go to the pending, again, I will get how many invoices are pending, and we can search it those one also. Yep. So, and at the main time, once it's processed, so this is a data extraction. Again, it's a list. MS Flow is using whatever the content has extracted using the AI builder and storing here all the defined, what the trained we have done our model. So it was just taking and just dumping the data here. Yep. So that's all from my side for this demo. Hope you'll get the more business use case in this one. Yep. Thank you.
And excellent. Over to you. Excellent. Yeah, thank you. Yeah, thank you, Paul, for this one. This is really, 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 really awesome set of cool scenarios for airline operations. So basically, how to use the Microsoft 365 platform as the model or the host for the airline operations. So using bots and using Microsoft Teams and storage and SharePoint and surfacing data and file of that. So really, really cool stuff. So awesome, awesome work on that one. I think a lot of the people who are watching this video will be like, oh, that's really, really cool. Cool scenarios. Thank you, Manoj.